friends ain't got shit on me. Cause I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, as you can see, I look so different. So as you can see by my thumbnail and the title of this video, I was inspired by the famous actress from Euphoria. Her name is Alexa Demi. I'm gonna put a picture right next to me on the picture I was inspired by. I saw so many people doing it and it's trendy, and I thought the look was so pretty. Like, I usually do like blown out eyeshadows. I love this look because I feel like it looks simple, but it's kind of tricky in a way, and I'm gonna show you why in the video. I'm gonna tell you why, but I just love this look as well. It's so different for me, coming out of my comfort zone, and yeah, it's so pretty. Like, I teach you tricks on how to do this eyeshadow, how, you know, just, I love that it lifts up your eyes as well. It just makes you look like you had an eye lift surgery, which I like. So I like about makeup, you could just put it on and transform into a different you and just look bomb. But yeah, if you want to learn all those tips and tricks on how you do like this foxy eye makeup tutorial, please keep watching. Do not forget to subscribe, give this video a big thumbs up, turn on your bell button right next to the subscribe button so every time I upload you're notified. Then yeah, let's just get to this video. Alright, so for today's palette, I'm gonna be using the Morphe 3503 palette. I love this palette because it has your bright colors, your neutrals, your browns, just everything. That's what I love about it, and the colors like are freaking bomb, like the way they blend and everything. So this look looks very easy and simple, but honestly I feel like it's kind of like tricky just because I feel like I'm so used to putting eyeshadow on top of eyeshadow, and this one it feels like you have to just, it's simple in the sense of less colors, but it's harder in the sense of like trying to blend it and make it look like you don't have a lot of eyeshadow. But then again, it gives like a fierce look at the same time, if you know what I mean. It was just hard for me as well picking the right brown for this, like a brown neutral, because I feel like some browns I have are too dark. They're either too dark, too brown, or like too light or too orangey. So I wanted like just the right amount of like a neutral brown. So this was like honestly the best brown I found, which is not exactly what I wanted, but it works. And I have a tip on like how to make it look more blended, like it looks like less. I'm just gonna show you. Alright, so the palette, I'm gonna use this shade right here. It's like a really light mocha shade, like a yellowish undertone. So I'm gonna use this Morphe R39. The reason I like this brush is because I'm gonna show you. So top of the axis, and I already primed my eyes. But I like this brush because first is like a fluffy brush. Like this one, the Morphe M441. So it focuses. So this one right here is more fluffy, so the bristles are gonna get more all over like the crease and eye, and I don't want that. Versus the one I'm using now, this one is more dense and the bristles are not gonna like, the bristles don't move that much and it's very stiff, and that's what I want for this kind of look. So yeah, I'm just taking that eyeshadow real close right here as well, so it has like an open, my eyes look way more open. And the look she does have is, you could tell it's like open right here. And I'm just not blending it like all the way up. I'm just stopping like right on the end of my eye and blending it very soft and just staying really focused on the crease, not on the lid or above the crease, just right on the crease. See, that brown is not too dark, not too orangey, it's just the perfect amount of color. So the next step is real easy. I'm gonna take the first shade in the palette. It's like a nude, really light nude kind of shade. I like this because it's not too white, and that's what I want. Don't want a white eyeshadow, I want like a nude base. So taking that all over the lid, kind of cutting the crease but without concealer. Using a flat brush, and I'm kind of marking that area too. This step was honestly like the easiest too. This next step, so I'm taking the Morphe M432, this is my definer brush. I'm gonna be mixing now, like, now I'm gonna go with my dark browns. These two, I'm gonna mix these. I have to mix them, but I like to, just cause, just in case, I like to work with a light one, just in case the other one comes out too dark and then it like evens out. What you can do as a beginner, like measure your eye. Kind of mimic if you're doing like a cat eye look, a wing liner, but just for eyeshadow. Just winging it out. See, it just lifts your eyes automatically and just gives that light. Your eyes lifted without surgery. There you go. Just gonna do my eyebrows real quick and... Alright, so for primer, I'm gonna be using the Milk Makeup Hydro Grip Primer. I've been loving this primer lately. It's like a little, it's like a cool gel feeling. It's so hydrating, and I like that your foundation just sticks to it and makes you look glowy as well. Alright, so for foundation, I'm gonna be mixing two of them, the Hourglass Vanish Stick and the Born This Way by Too Faced. Gonna be mixing these two. So I like the coverage of the Born This Way, is a really full coverage. I also like the finish to it, and the Hourglass, I love the finish to it as well. So, but it's not that full coverage like how I want it, so that's why I like mixing the two. I'm gonna take my sponge with the Born This Way foundation, just blend it all together. See how instantly it's just like full coverage. And I'm gonna be using the Morphe Fluidity Concealer. I'm gonna spray some spray on my sponge. It's a little dry, so I like to like melt the concealer in. Also, I feel like concealer will help with this look. Okay, you could put concealer like right there. I'll show you afterwards, but just to clean it up, and it's gonna make it look more fierce. You could just grab any like thin brush. Gonna grab some concealer. Put it close to the eyeliner. Blend it. Alright, so I'm doing my usual face routine. Have you seen my, it's two videos ago, my makeup tutorial. It's the same face routine, so I'm just gonna like skim through most of it. So I'm gonna set my face off camera, do mostly everything off camera, and then I'm just gonna show like my highlight, lipstick, and no, I'm gonna come back and do my rest of my face off camera, then show my under eyes. But I'm gonna do my under eyes, and then from there I just film it, and then yeah, so I'll be right back. Alright, so I did most of my face off camera, and I'm gonna go back to the under eyes. A dark brown. I'm gonna take this brown right here and mix it with this dark brown right there for my under eyes, because I want it to look very smoky. Josa has a line like pointing down, so that's what I'm gonna do as well. I'm gonna take the really dark brown shade, take the same brush, point it down like that, I guess. Now I'm just gonna take a fluffy brush. I like to do this just to make it look more smoky, and like, I'm gonna take this color right here. No, this color. Kind of put that underneath and blend it all together. See, that just makes it look way better. I like to do this when I'm baking too, because you could wipe away if you did too much. Now I'm gonna take off the powder. Alright, so I'm gonna do my lashes off camera and I'll be right back. All Alright, so then my lashes off camera. Now I'm just up to my blush. Gonna be using my Milani blush. For lipstick, I wanted to do something a little different. So I'm gonna be taking the Il Makiage x Cardi Babil waterproof lip liner in the shade Luna. So it's like a nude brown. I'm gonna take this Maybelline lipstick in the shade Beige Babe. I'm gonna take some of that gloss that came with the collection. It's the Star Child gloss. Looks like this. Alright, so I quickly applied highlight and I add a little mole, you know, just to like the picture she had. Now I'm gonna make the look come together. Black eyeliner all over my waterline. Alright, you guys, this is the finished look. I just put a little bit of gel and like twisted it. I'm not good with hair, so I'm loving this look. I feel like I look so different, but I like it at the same time. It's giving me like 60s vibes. I hope you guys learned a lot of tips and tricks in this video. Please let me know what you want to see next, and please subscribe, hit that bell button right next to the subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.